morning students. In my previous video, I explained you why electric current generates heat. And in this video, we will learn to derive the formula for calculating the heat energy generated when electric current is passing through a wire. Now students, we know that when electric current passes through a wire, the wire offers resistance. The current continuously works to overcome the resistance for its continuous flow. Now take an example. Now suppose there is a wire and say I current is passing through it, and this wire is offering a resistance of R, and the current is passing through the wire for time t. Now suppose, see, when Q charge is flowing through it against a potential difference of V, then the amount of work done by the flowing charge is given by W is equal to V into Q. And as students, we have learned that I is equal to Q by T. Now see, we can write Q is equal to I into T. And from Ohm's law, we can write V is equal to IR. Now putting the value of V, that is IR here, and Q I into T here, we get the relation W is equal to I into R into I into T. That is W is equal to I square R T. Now student, assuming that all the electric energy consumed, all the work done here is converted into heat energy, we can write it W is equal to H is equal to I square R T. That is H is equal to I square R T. Now see, this is the formula that we use for calculating the heat energy generated when the current is passing through a conductor. And here H is representing the heat energy generated, I is representing the current passing through it, R is representing the resistance of the conductor, and T here is representing the time for which the current is passing through it. Now student, this relation H is equal to I square RT is also known as Joule's law of heating. According to Joule's law of heating, the heat produced when current passed through a conductor is directly proportional to the square of the current. That is, H is directly proportional to the square of the current, and it is also directly proportional to the resistance, and it is also directly proportional to time. It means the heat energy produced in the conductor depends on the current, on the resistance, and on the time interval. Now see this relation. The heat energy is directly proportional to the square of the current. It means when we double the current, the heat energy produced will become 4 times. Now, if we halve the current, it will become 1/4. Now, what about resistance? When we double the resistance of the conductor, the heat energy produced will be doubled. And for time, it is also clear that heat energy is directly proportional to time. Means when we double the time, the heat energy will get doubled. So heat energy produced in a conductor depends on 3 factors, that is on the current, on the resistance and on the time. And students, I think you followed this relation very clearly. That's all. Thank you.